students. Today, for your literature, we will be doing a chapter from your poem. That is chapter 4, After Blenheim. So, After Blenheim is written by Robert Southey, who was born in the year 1774. He died in 1843. And if we talk about his works, there are many works that he contributed to the Waterloo Review. He became a very well known by 1813 that he was appointed the poet laureate by Walter Scott, refused the post. Okay. And in 1808, he met Walter Savage Landor, who whose work he admired and became very close friends. There are many poems written, autobiography, and then the Inchcape Rock is also, then the God's Judgment on a Wicked Bishop, After Blenheim is also a very, very renowned, known poem, which is an anti-war poems, which can be counted in the anti-war poems. Okay, so line-wise explanation for the first stanza. It was a summer evening, old Casper's work was done. I will only read the explanation of the lines. Okay, two paragraphs, both the two paragraphs I'll be explaining. So what happens, what is the starting of the poem is, there is a very strong character named old Casper. So he is a farmer. Okay, what happens, there it starts with a pastoral image where there is there is a very varied picture of a countryside, okay, in the backdrop of a warm afternoon. And then a small stream is also where an old man is like watching calmly, and watching, what he is watching is this old Casper after doing his day's work, he is basking in the sun. Okay, he is basking in the sun and just watching what his grandchildren are doing. The grandchildren are playing. Two grandchildren he has. One is Wilhelmine and the other is Peterkin. So they were playing and he is just watching them after doing his daily course. So what happened, this evokes, what does it evokes? It evokes the warmth of the family. Okay, that literal warmth of the sun, along with the literal warmth of the sun. And then summer itself evokes the feeling of warmth, peace and tranquility. Okay, then I find them in the garden. After that, what happens? He saw his brother, brother Peterkin rolled something large and round, which he beside the rivulet in playing there had found. He came to ask what he had found. That was a large, smooth and round. So all of a sudden, playing wise, these two brother and sister, what they see is Peterkin sees So Wilhelmine sees that her brother Peterkin is picking up something round, smooth object. Now they don't know what the object is. So what happens, they bring it to their grandfather, old Casper, and in order to ask, you know, there is lot of curiosity among children to know new things, what is that object, these, that, so many questions. So they are not clear with what is the object, so they come to their grandfather to ask, in order to inquire. So after that, old Casper took it from the boy who stood expectant by, and the old man shook his head with a natural sigh. This some poor skulls. So what happens? This old Casper is taking away the skull. So that is the skull. That object is considered to be object because the Peterkin and Wilhelmine are unknown about it. So that's why it's called a object. But that is actually a skull. Now whose skull it is? Okay, and these Wilhelmine and Peterkin are very eagerly, anxiously waiting for the reply from their grandfather. So then what happens, this old man is very noisily, is replying in a very smooth and round thing that the skull of some unfortunate man. So this is the skull of some unfortunate man who had died in the battle of Blenheim. Okay, so he is replying like that. Then he is also adding that these skulls are very much rarely, very much commonly found in these villages, field where I work. I keep on getting all those, so that's not a new thing for me. That's why he is just giving a natural sigh. It's called natural sigh because he is habituated with that. Okay. Then he says that the plowshare turns them out, for many thousand men said were slain in that great victory. He is also adding said that there was a victory, there was a battle in Blenheim, so there was that battle resulted to many killing. Okay, 1,000 people were all rotted down in the ground, their skulls are everywhere, found everywhere. So this might be the skull of some unfortunate person who died in that great victory, that means that battle. Okay, fine. Then after this, now tell us what it was all about, young Peterkin, he cries, and the little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder waiting eyes. Now tell us all about the war and what was they fought each other for. Yes, curiosity. So again, the children are very much curious. Grandfather has already told them that this is a skull of some unfortunate. Now they want to know how the skull had come there. Okay, so they just want to know about the war, what was the drawback, what was the consequence, how did the war happen. So many questions were all, they were very much curious, especially the grandchild. Okay, more than Wilhelmine, Peterkin was more eager to know about it. So then he said, it was then English Caspar cried, who put the French to rout. But what they fought each other for, I could not make out. And every day said, quoth he, that it was a famous victory. Okay, then he says that there was a fight between the English and the French. Okay, so who were the winner? The Britishers. Okay, they fought against the French and the French lost. Okay, so and then who was the winner? The English, that means the British. So that was the fight between the English and the French. Okay, in that battle only many many French soldiers, armies were killed. So it might be the dead body of skull of some this man. But I cannot actually tell you the reason of the fight. I only know through my source as well as through my grandparents and my parents that it was a great victory. That is only known to me. But the reason of fighting, and then what is the circumstance, what was the aftermath of the victory, I can tell you, but I cannot tell you the reason of his their fight. The reason of the war is still unknown to me. Okay, he is only telling that it was a great victory. That means whatever he knows, he is just giving that message. He is just passing out that message to his grandchildren. Okay, my father lived at Blenheim then, yon little stream hard by. They burned his dwelling to the ground and he was forced to fly. So with his wife and child he fled, nor had he where to rest his head. So what happened? He was talking about that time. It was a time when my father was forced to leave this place. Leave this place by the Britishers. The Britishers had forced my father, my father's house were burned. He was forced to migrate from that place, along taking away his wife and child. That child is actually, that unfortunate child is me, old Caspar says. Okay, so I was forced to leave this place there and then migrate, and it was a condition where we were not having any shelter elsewhere. So that was the condition. Okay, we had to leave the place and go. That was the time when the war had taken place, Blenheim. With fire and sword, the country round was wasted far and wide, and many a children, mother then, a newborn baby died, and things like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. Okay, and he's also adding up the situation, saying that there are many people, that time many people died mercilessly, without, innocent people had died, many newborn children were dead, fathers, their wives, everybody, okay. Those pregnant ladies were also affected, that means those children who are not even taken birth were also being killed by these enemies. Okay, enemies means those English people. Okay, then the next paragraph, they say it was a shocking sight. The last paragraph, they say it was a shocking sight after the field was won, for many thousand bodies lay rotting in the sun, but things like that, you know, must be after a famous victory. Now soon after that, whatever happened is just a message, it's just an information to me. I've nothing not seen through my own eyes. I just heard that there were lot of killing. okay, many destruction had taken place, and what was the result, what did they on, that was all unknown. But I only assure you, I just know that that was a great victory. That is a remarkable one, unforgettable moment, okay, for each one of us. Great praise the Duke of Marlborough won, and our good Prince Eugene. Why it were a very very wicked thing, said little Wilhelmine. Nay, my little girl, quoth he. It was a famous victory. Okay, and he is also saying that everybody were praising whom? The Duke of Marlborough, who won. That means the English commander. The English commander, Duke of Marlborough, was appreciated and well praised by everybody because he was the winner. And who was the Prince Eugene was fighting from the French army. Okay, he was the head, he was the commander of the French. So even though he also that was a very diplomatic, he was a very diplomatic man. So he fought, though he was also appreciated, but the winning trophy went in the hands of Duke of Marlborough. And I tell you that it was a great victory. Everybody knows about the victory, but they only know that it was great. They don't know the reason of fighting, they don't know what they got, and everything is unknown. But only one sentence everybody of us know is that it was a great victory. Now something if happens that makes a very torn in our life also, that we don't know anything about it, but we remember that it was great. For example, of many centuries later, maybe we'll be talking about this virus, right? Because this also created a lot of destructions. So this is a kind of incidents, no, that keeps on hitting humans every mind. Okay, though we don't know the reason, and it's a kind of biased reason, we don't know the reason. Okay, so everybody praised the Duke who this great fight did win, but what good came of it at last, quote little Peterkin. Why? That I cannot tell, said he, but it was a famous victory. Okay, and again, when he is completely saying that thousands of lives are killed, Wilhelmine, the granddaughter, is telling what was the good thing that happened. Okay, she is a small child and she is very much eager to know, because she knows the winner always gets some trophy or something winning. Like, what is their winning? They killed so many people, many died, so what was their what did they win? But father, grandfather is unable to tell them what was the prize that they got, the English army. Okay, so he is telling, I don't think anything happened good for the because of the war that had prevailed. But he only knows that the war, it was a great war, it was a great victory, it brought so many changes in everybody's life. That was only told by old Casper. Okay, so this is actually the poem. Through this is an anti-war poem, because it brings a lot of drawbacks. So see, for example, if the war happens between two countries, there are so many people who simply get killed, right? Though they are they are so innocent, but still they get killed. So these are the consequences of the war. These are the situations that happens when one person is affected, because if the country is getting affected. So this poem is actually written as an anti-war poem. It's a lot of thousands of corpses we talked about, no? Since right from the skull, and he's talking about all those things that happened in this poem after Blenheim. So question answer of this will be soon uploaded to you. Meanwhile, you all listen to the video and try to know many things more than this. Thank you.